Fellow greetings, my brothers and sisters. To God be the glory for all of the great things that the Lord has done and all that God is doing. It's a joy to be able to come to your home this morning by social media. I want you to know that God has truly been good to us. And as we gather this morning, just to encourage you, our listeners out there, remember that there is a God who sits high and he looks down low. You can rest assured that God has his arms around us and his eyes is upon us. And remember, my brothers and sisters, that there's nothing too hard for the Lord. So I kind of enjoy to be able to stand here this morning to encourage somebody to hold on just a little while longer. You can rest assured that help is on the way. Let us pray. God, our Father, it's again that we gather one more time to tell you thank you. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. We thank you, God, because you allowed us to see a day that we've never seen before and will never see again. We thank you for how you dispatch your angel to watch over us as we stumble and slept on last night. And early this morning, you touched us with a finger of love and allowed our golden moments to roll on just a little while longer. Oh God, our Father, we understand that somebody walked before all night long. Somebody tossed and turned all night long, wondering where they would ever come. But because you being who you are, you watch over them and you kept them. We ask now that thou would look upon that young boy, that young girl, that man, that woman who don't even know you and pardon their sin. But help them to understand that there is a God who loves and cares for us. You loved us so much you gave your son, and the son gave his life. God, you promised to be a doctor in our sick room, a lawyer in our courtroom. You promised to be a bridge over our troubled water. Oh God, you promised to be a shelter in the time of storm. And Lord, we just want to tell you thank you. We thank you, God, because we understand that all power is in your hands. We ask now, Lord, that thou would bless our going out and bless our coming in. One more time, as the Spirit of the living God fall fresh upon us, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. My brothers and sisters, as we were spending time with God, as we always do in the course of this week, asking God to give us a word that would encourage the listeners of this United States of America, to encourage the world to hold on just a little while longer. I want you to look at me briefly this morning as we gather through social media out of an Old Testament scripture, very familiar scripture, the 103rd Psalm. The 103rd Psalm. You find words of encouragement in these. I'm going to read the first five verses of the 103rd Psalm. You find these words. Whereas the psalmist now, what he says in the 103rd Psalm, where he said, "O bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Forget not all of his benefits. Who forgive thine iniquity, who heals all thy disease, who redeemeth the life from destruction, who cover thee with a loving kindness and tender mercy." The fifth verse says, "Who satisfied my mouth with good things, so that the youth is renewed like eagles." I want you to look with me briefly out of that second verse. The second verse said, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits." I want to know that I'm grateful to the Lord this morning. I must share my testimony. I thank God that I'm saved. I thank God for the gift of the Holy Ghost. I thank God I can still stand firm and say that I know that, I know that, I know I know that my Redeemer lives. My brothers and sisters, when I think about the goodness of Jesus and all that the Lord has done for me, when I think about what God has brought, my soul cries out, hallelujah. I thank God for saving me. Those of you who are not saved, I want you to know there's a joy in being saved. I don't know about you, but I would live a life like I live in today without being saved. So as we now look at this 103rd Psalm, I want you to look at me, and I'm going to use for a thought, you can depend on God's benefit. We're living in a society where folks are always looking for benefits. It doesn't matter whether you're on a job and you're employed, you want to know what is the benefit. The pay scale may not be where you want it to be, but if the benefits are right. So I want you to know that you can depend on God's benefit. And I want you to know that every believer out there, you ought to read the Psalms. In these Psalms, you will find words that occur when you're going through your lonely moments. And in the book of Psalms, you will find words of encouragement that will assure you that everything is going to be all right. So here we find now the writer in this song began to remind us of a declaration concerning who God really is. We're living in a world where folks are not sure that they can depend on anything or anyone. But when you look at the word depend, it means to be controlled or determined by. And what I love about it is you can rely on. And my brothers and sisters, you can rely on God, even in the hour and the time of this coronavirus. You can still depend on God's benefit because his benefit said that he won't leave us, neither will he forsake us. In other words, we're talking about what is the word benefit? Benefit is an advantage or profit gained from something, or a payment or a gift made by an employee or a state of insurance company. But the real benefit is to receive advantage or proof and profit, knowing that God will take care of us. We find this in the Bible verse said, for God said, and you find God said in Isaiah 41 and 13, and in the NIV version said, for I am the Lord your God, who takes hold of your right hand and say to you, there you dare not fear, for I will help you. I'm grateful today to know that we can depend on God's benefit. We live in a time now where men, women, boys, and girls are troubled and confused on every side. So something began reminding us how I know that you can depend on God's benefit. But first of all, you must get acquainted with the benefit. You'll find reference to the benefit all through the Bible. From Genesis to Revelation, talk about the benefit that God has for us. So on this song, I said now, but I will bless the Lord at all times. My brothers and sisters, the reason I know that you depend on him, because if you just give God some praise and give God some glory and tell the Lord thank you for, despite of the storm that you are going through. Somebody right now worried what tomorrow going to hold. But I want you to know tomorrow is not promised. Because the scripture said, this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I'm grateful today that I can tell you about a God that you can depend on. A God who promised never to leave us or neither forsake us. So here what the psalmist said, if I bless the Lord in my dark hours, if I bless the Lord and when the sun is shining, if I bless the Lord when my way dark and dreary, I know that I have a benefit that he will take care of me. So here what the psalmist said now, oh bless the Lord on my soul and all that is within me. And the psalmist didn't stop there, but he said, forget not his benefits. And my brothers and sisters, as we journey through this hour of what we're dealing with, the uncertainty, but I thank God this morning, we have a God that we can depend on. And the Bible is filled with evidence that you can depend on God's benefit. If I had to pause just for a moment this morning, and I could call on some reference to give me the reassurance that I can depend on God's benefit. I said, Moses, can you help me out? Just a little while. Moses said to the children of Israel while they were going through their pledges. God told Moses to tell Israel that they can depend on my benefit. And Moses said, God, I need something to give them evidence that they can depend on your benefit. God said, Moses, you tell them, put the blood on the doorpost. And when I send my angel, when I see the blood, the benefit is that the blood will cover them. I stand by to tell you, everybody has not yet connected with the benefit. If you want this benefit, you've got to be born again. You got to know that you know that you know that God is a God who makes ways out of nowhere. And God said to Moses, tell the children of Israel, I'm going to give them a benefit. If they put the blood on the doorpost, I will pass over when I see the blood. And I thank God this morning that I know that I can depend on God's benefit. We find that God's benefit, he will redeem the life from destruction. Now, it doesn't matter whatever comes or goes, I know that God is my shepherd. And I know that he's going to redeem us from all of the destruction that's going on around us. God loves his children, and God will take care of the children. I want you to know, my brothers and sisters, sometimes it may seem like we at the cross we're about to give up. But I want you to know if you hold on, and if you hold out just a little while longer, help is on the way. So we find help as we feel, as we go through learning how to depend on God's benefit.
We ought to recognize the fact that many of God's chosen servants had gone through some storm. But one thing they knew, if I keep God's benefit, I'll make it through all right. Remember, Peter went to the Lord. Paul went to God three times. God said, Paul said, Lord, I have a thorn in my flesh. But God said, Paul, I want you to know my grace is your benefit. Don't worry about the thorn in your flesh. Somebody somewhere have a thorn in their flesh. Somebody somewhere are going through some trials and tribulation. But God benefit have a whole lot of mercy and a whole lot of grace. Can I get a witness? You got to know who God's benefit is. We find in this 130 song, he said, oh, satisfy my mouth with good things. I stop by to tell you, when you're under God's benefit, you can rest assured that you have protected him. You can rest assured that God will fight your battle. Anybody know, as long as I got the benefit of the Lord, the enemies can't do me no harm. As long as I have God's benefit, God's benefit is a protector, and he is a shield. Sometime I stop by to tell you, weeping and mourning may endure for a night, but the benefit of knowing that God, he wiped the tears from my eyes. I thank God this morning as I stand out here to tell you about God's benefit. Sometimes, my brothers and sisters, when the song began to talk about, you can rest assured, you can depend on God's benefit. Well, let me help you out just a little while. In order to be able to depend on God's benefit, first of all, you got to know who Jesus is. You got to know that he's a bridge over troubled water. You got to know that he is the Redeemer of the world. I'm so glad that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Anybody know that there's a benefit in serving a truly living God? But what, let me share this with you. If you want to enjoy God's benefit, first of all, you got to get in the plan. It doesn't matter how much you hear about the plan, but if you want to ever buy into the plan, if you want to ever meet Jesus, you want to experience his benefit. And I stand there to tell you, the Lord said, not everyone that says unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter to the kingdom of God. Just because you go to church, that don't mean you're in God's benefit. Just because you sing on the choir, that does not mean that you're in God's benefit. Just because you worship at the door, that doesn't mean that you're in God's benefit. A whole lot of preachers preach in the pulpit, but they're not under God's benefit. But Brother Smalls, how can I be in God's benefit? If you don't believe, you ask Nicodemus. Nicodemus came to Jesus one night. He said, Rabbi, I know that thou art a teacher, because no man can do these things that thou do. They said, God, be with him. The Lord said, Nicodemus, you mean to tell me you teaching in the synagogue, but you don't know my benefit. My benefit is you've got to be born again. I wish I had some help. I wish I had somebody to know. There's a joy in being covered by God's benefit. One thing I know, that I can depend on God's benefit. I'm never alone, because he promised never to leave me. He promised never to forsake me. And the psalmist said, when you're covered by God's benefit, he will protect you from all evil, evil on every side, evil all around us. But there's a God who's in front of us, and there's a God who's behind us. There's a God who sits high up and he lives down low. When your enemies start shooting their fiery dart, you don't have to worry, because you got God's benefit. And as long as I have God's benefit, I know that I know everything gonna be all right. Can I get a witness? But let it move on now. We find in Matthew 6:34, the word of God is quicker and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword. See, that lets me know I have the benefit that will shield me, the benefit that will take me, the benefit that will protect me. See, sometimes we're going through now, they're laying off on jobs. When you lose your job, you might lose your benefit. But I somebody to tell you, if you stay with the Lord, you will never lose your benefit. I know, he promised, he's an Alpha and Omega, on the beginning and the end. I can open doors for you, and no man can close them. I somebody to tell you, there's a joy in depending on God's benefit. Some of us, we learn how to depend on the government, but I learned how to depend on the Lord. The psalmist said, some trust in horses, some trust in chariots, but I will trust in the Lord. Can I get with you? There's a joy in knowing that you can depend on God's benefit. I stand by to tell you, if you trust God with all your heart, and you trust God with all your heart, you can praise him early in the morning. You can praise him late in the midnight hour. I wish I had somebody who knew that there's a joy in depending on the Lord. I stop by to tell you, it doesn't matter who your employee is. It doesn't matter what status you have on your job. It doesn't matter what status you wear in your community. But if you don't know Jesus, you have a bad benefit. If you don't know Jesus, your benefit is no good. Some people depend on men, but I depend on the Lord. Can I get a witness that you can depend on God's benefit? It doesn't matter what the doctor says, but you ought to tell him that God made me in his own image. And everything God made, he said it was good. That's a part of the benefit package. The part of the benefit package is you can't live unholy and still have the benefit package. But I declare, once you give your life to the Lord, he wraps you up in his benefit package. How you know it, Reverend? Over 3,000 years ago, over 2,000 years ago, God looked at the world that he created in his own image. God looked at the world that he made in his own image. God saw men that he made that turned their backs on God. God saw the world. I know I have a benefit plan, and the benefit plan is I'm gonna give them a savior. His name is Jesus. Mary, little baby, he came down through 42 generations. He walks with me, he talks with me, he tells me that I am his own, and include this benefit package. He hung on the cross, he hung from the 6th to the 9th hour. They spit him in the side. Blood and water came trembling down. I heard Jesus echoing the Calvary cross. He said, Father, into thy hand I commend my spirit. He sealed the benefit. Can I get a witness? I stand by to tell you, there's a joy in having a benefit package with the Lord. One thing I know, as long as I keep this benefit, I can't go wrong. See, you got to understand, this old world is not my home. I'm just a pilgrim passing through. But the benefit is, when I get through laboring down here, when I get through serving down here, the benefit is, I'm going home to live with Jesus. Can I get a witness? The Bible said, how you know there's a benefit? It's because in my Father's house, there are many mentioned. And he said, if it were not so, I would have told you. I wouldn't stand here this morning and tell you that you can depend on God's benefit if I hadn't tried him for myself. Can I get a witness? There's a joy in knowing that I have benefit in the Lord. And the benefit is, when I get sick, he's going to be my doctor. The benefit is, If I get in trouble, he won't be my lawyer. The benefit is, if my friend walk away and leave me, he promised me that he would never leave me. The benefit is, I heard David said, I know that I can depend on God's benefit. He said, my mother and my father, they may forsake me, but I have some benefit knowing that the Lord, he's going to take me in. So I stand by to tell you, I'm closing now. But some of us out there, you don't know Jesus. You're depending on the wrong stuff. Some folks always feel like I'm not ashamed to tell you, some people depend on alcohol, some people depend on drugs, some people depend on sex, but I depend on the Lord, because I know that I can trust God. I know that God, he's going to wipe the tears from my eyes, and he reminded me in the 103rd Psalm, and in the second verse, he said, forget not my benefit. I want you to know why you're going through. Don't forget about your benefit. Why your back is against the wall? Don't you forget about God's benefit. Your food may get low, but don't worry. If you keep seeing God's benefit, he will supply your needs. I've never seen a righteous forsaken, not a seedbed prayed. I want you to know, my listeners, you can depend on God's benefit. One thing about God's benefit is a path that won't ever go back. One thing about God's benefit, I dare you to try. If you ever try, your life will never be the same. Dreaming of us talk about God's benefit is no good. The reason why we say it's no good, because we never really try. Jesus said, not everyone that says unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of God. But he that do the will of my Father. My brothers and sisters, if you ever purchased, if you ever plugged in, if you ever tried God's benefit, you will never walk away from it. There, you can depend on God's benefit. Not that you can depend on other songs. Not that you can depend on Bethel, AME Church. But you can depend on God's benefit. God's benefit is what we all need, my brothers and sisters. Just to remind you that once you receive this gift and advantage, when you get through toiling down here in the heat of the day, Jesus said, in my Father's house. And the psalmist said, but if we're dealing with, let us not forget his benefits. And if you don't forget God's benefit, is a declaration concerning men. There will be a time that men need to learn how to trust God. We need to know that if you trust God, he can take you from the worst sin that you in. And he rewards you with joy, peace, and happiness. The benefit is, as far God will cast your sin as far as from the east to the west. My brothers and sisters, you can depend on God's benefit. Don't let the enemy fool you. Don't let the devil fool you. If you stay with God, there is a reward in his benefit. And so I thank God this morning for allowing me to come into your homes by the way of social media, because if there's ever been a time that we need to be encouraged, now is the time. Everybody everywhere are looking for something that they can depend on. Some of us depend on different things of the world, but the best gift that I can share with you is that you can depend on God. The psalmist said, oh, bless the Lord on my soul, and all that within me, bless his holy name. You find in the first two verses, he quote those same words twice, reminding us that we can depend on his benefit. And he said in the second verse, forget not all of my benefit. Don't let nobody fool you. Don't let anybody discourage you. Even this coronavirus gonna pass over. If Protestant believers keep the faith and start depending on God's benefit, not the president, not the governor, not the mayor, not the pastor, but you have to depend on God's benefit. So because God said that I go to prepare a place for you. If I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again. So again, my brothers and sisters, as we close out in this
message this morning of words of encouragement, you can depend on God's benefit. Somebody out there had felt like throwing in the towel. Somebody was at the crossroad and wondering which way to go. Somebody said, I've been in the church, I've done everything I can do, I've done all that I knew what to do, but you have not yet leaned on God's benefit. When you learn how to lean on God's benefit, the world can't do you no harm. In my conclusion, I just want to remind you of this. His benefit said that he'll make your enemies become the footstool, so you can depend on God's benefit. Father God, it's again that we come before your throne one more time to tell you thank you. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. And most of all, God, we thank you for your word. The psalmist said, thy word are hid within my heart, that I will not sin against thee. I ask now, God, that thou will bless every listener out there in the social media world. Help them to understand, despite of who you are, where you've been, if you ever learn how to depend on God's benefit, he'll reach way down. He'll pick you up. He will turn you around. He'll place your feet on solid ground. Oh, bless the Lord on my soul and all that is within me. And help me to understand that the Lord said to you one more time, don't forget of all his benefit. God, we just want to thank you. Thank you. Look upon that mother. Look upon that father. Look upon that son. Restore families, God. Restore churches. Restore our community. God, help us to understand that your benefit will never fail. You are the Alpha and the Omega. You're the beginning and you're the end. We ask now that these and many more blessings be accepted. In Jesus' name we pray. You can depend on God's benefit.